हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आज मैं ये हैंड एनालाइज करने जा रही हूँ। ये मेरे एक सब्सक्राइबर का हैंड है और ये साउथ इंडिया से हैं। इन्होंने मुझे बोला है कि इस वीडियो को आप इंग्लिश में बनाना क्योंकि ये हिंदी में ज़्यादा कंफर्टेबल नहीं है, तो ये वीडियो मैं आज इंग्लिश में बनाने वाली हूँ। तो अभी मैं स्टार्ट करने वाली हूँ, पर उससे पहले मैं आपको ये बता दूँ कि अगर आप भी अपना हैंड मेरे से एनालाइज करवाना चाहते हैं तो आप मेरा डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स चेक कर लेना इस वीडियो के नीचे। वहाँ पर आपको सारी डिटेल्स वगैरह मिल जाएंगी, आप मुझसे कैसे कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं और फी वगैरह। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं इनका हैंड को एनालाइज करना। Let's start. So this is her hand. She asked me some questions. So first of all, I wanna give answers of her questions. So she asked me when I get married, love or arrange for foreign journey, future analysis. So I'll give answers of her question first. She use her right hand the most. So I'm going to analyze her right hand first. So your marriage will be love marriage because there are some signs which shows that you will get married with that person with whom you may fall in love or with whom you may wish to be married. So there are some lines like you have this sign in your hand, like here is your fate line and there is another sister line going on. So this indicates that you may have your life partner of your choice. And the second thing is there is your sun line and there is also a small line which is going to your heart line. So the second sign is this, that you may have your life partner of your choice. Your marriage will be of your choice. So this is the answer of your question number one. And second is you asked me that will you go to the abroad or not. So now I'll check that thing also. So yeah, you will go to abroad definitely, because there is 2-3 symbols that shows that you will travel to abroad, because there is a sister line and it indicates that yes, you will have long travel in your life. And your fate line also ends, it is going towards the sun mount. So this is the second indication that you may travel to the foreign land. But when I cannot tell you that when you will go to foreign country, in which age, because it is very difficult to predict that age. But yeah, in your lifetime you will definitely go to foreign country, or you I think you can also settle down there. So there is the answer of your second question. And now I'll do a full analysis of your hand. I'll take one picture of her right hand because she told me that she use right hand the most. So always analyze that hand which is active, we use one hand the most. Like some people are lefty but some people use their right hands. So the color of your hand is good, and because there is pinkish glow on every mount of your hand and fingertips also. So this is a good thing. And these kind of people, they have that much amount of money every time which is required. So it is very good indication. So second thing is your fingers. So now I'll talk about your fingers. Your fingers are they are very small as compared to your palm. So they are very small. So these kind of people, they are very fast in taking decisions. This kind of thing is like they take decisions in a very fast way. Like if you want to go somewhere, you will pack your bag and you will leave the house. You will not think that much about that thing. Like I'm not telling that get up and pack your bag and go to that place. It's not like that, but yeah, you don't take time to make your decisions. You are a very quick decision maker. So this thing is very good, but there is a bad thing also about this, because these kind of people sometimes they have to bear some loss because they don't think that much. So that's the thing. And this next thing is your palm is in rectangle shape. So these kind of palm, they do mental work and they like to do mental work very much. They don't like to do physical work that much, but your palm is not that thin, it is thick, and it shows that you have energy. If you have to do the physical work, you do that thing very, you know, nicely, because you have that energy in your palm. But yeah, you always, most of the time you always wanted to sit and do your work while sitting, like, you know, in banks we go, there are so many people who are working there, and they are sitting on a chair and, you know, doing their job, because they mostly they have a rectangle shape kind of hand, because that's the job they are doing, and that's the, they have that kind of nature also. And you are the same person, and whenever you want to do something in your life, like job or business, I didn't ask you about this thing, that what you do, are you working somewhere, or you have something, you know, business kind of thing. This is the advice, you know, from my side, that if you want to do something, like, you have to do that thing, kind of thing, like, you have to do that kind of job in which you don't have to go out and, you know, you don't have to do the field work or the physical work. So you have to sit on your chair or on your seat, and you have to manage the things. These kind of people, they actually make others to work for them. So they manage the things very well. And the second thing is, your thumb is very big. Not very big, but it is in medium size length. So this is the another thing that is good. If you have, if someone have this kind of thumb, so these kind of people, they are very good in, you know, managing the things. The logic part is very big, and the will part is very small. So this again indicates that you should manage the things. You should, you know, make the people work for you. These kind of people who have very big logic part, they are kind of people whose thinking power is very high, and they are very good in planning also. You can also make people to work very well for you. You have that you know, power in your hand. So your willpower is very small, so there is no need to, you know, have willpower very good, because your hand is completely, you know, it is a rectangle shaped hand. So whenever you want to work somewhere, or you want to start your business, so you should do that kind of business where you have not to go to the physical work very much. There is a very good island sign in your thumb, and it is called Yav sign in Hindi. It is very good, because it, you know, as you can see, it is closed, completely closed. It is not open like this. It is not open. So it is very good sign, and it indicates that you will acquire a very good amount of money in your life. So now I'll analyze your fingers. First of all, your Jupiter finger, here is your Jupiter finger. So it is crooked slightly. So you have leadership quality in you, but not that much high, but you have a good leadership quality. So your Jupiter finger is bigger than your Sun finger. So it indicates that you will have so much opportunities in your life, and you are a Jupiterian. These kind of people, they are very much, you know, ambitious, and they want to do something in their life, and they achieve almost they achieve their goal in life when they follow their dreams, and when they work for their dreams. So next is your Saturn finger. It is, you know, it is straight. I'll talk about your Sun fingers. Your Sun finger is slightly smaller than your Jupiter finger, so it indicates that you will not take a risk. You are your nature, you know, you are not that kind of girl who takes so much risk in her life. You don't want to take so much risk in your life. You always want to do things like in a very careful way. You don't want to take so much risk in your life. So this is the kind of nature you have. Next is your Mercury finger, and your Mercury finger is very good, because it is crooked slightly. It is crooked, as you can see, it is, you know, bending towards your Sun finger. So this thing is very, very good, because it indicates that you are, you know, very you are kind of a person, if you like something to do in your life, like if you are interested in something, like if you like to do painting, or if you like to do you know, cooking, you will be pro in that thing. The this type of people, they are very pro in those things which they love to do the most. And they become professional in those things. Like if you're a makeup artist or if you're a teacher, if you're a doctor, you will be pro in your profession because of this thing, because your Mercury finger is crooked. So it is touching your first, finger, sun finger, first phalange. So this is another thing that you are a very outspoken kind of person. You are not very shy. If you have to talk with higher authority people, you can talk with them very easily. So this thing indicates this. So next, now we'll talk about the mounts. So let's talk about the mounts. So first of all, your Mercury mount. Your Mercury mount is very, very good, and your Mercury finger, it was also very good. Like it is, its length was very good, and your Mercury mount, like here, it is also good, but not that much. I will not say that very high quality type of Mercury mount you have. No, it is not like that, but yeah, it is okay kind of. So you have some lines on your Mercury mount, like 2-3 lines. So this indicates that you will not face any problem regarding money in your life, liquid money in your life. You will always have liquid money with you. I cannot see anything else on your Mercury mount in this picture. Your sun mount is good. It is okay. So your sun line, it is going, like as you can see, it is going towards the defensive Mars, like here in on this area. So it indicates that in future or right now you will earn like royalty kind of income. Like some people, they write books, and their books they keep on selling their books lifetime, and they get royalty income from that books, because they have to do work for only once, and they get money from that work throughout the life. So this kind of sun line indicates that these kind of people can also invest their money in share market. Like this kind of sun line gives that kind of money. So your sun line is good, and it starts from here, like very slightly, and then it is going upwards towards the sun mount. I cannot see any kind of sign on your sun mount, but you have this loop in between your Mercury finger and sun finger. This loop indicates that you have a very good kind of sense of humor. You have industrial loop right here on your hand, and it indicates that if you want to do a business, and you can make your business grow bigger because of this loop, and this loop is a very good sign on hand. Your sun line starts from this age, so it is very big, and it starts from like your age is 33, you told me, and from this age you will feel that you are getting fame and respect from this age. Like your age is 33, and from this age, or maybe from 34, you will feel that you are getting that respect and fame from the society you are living right now. So this sun line, it will give you the respect and fame and money also, and your sun line is very big. It is starting from this point, and this age is near about 32-33. So that was the analysis of your sun mount. Now we'll go to your Saturn mount. So this is your Saturn mount, and it is like not very flat and not very big. So your Saturn finger is very, very long. So your Saturn mount is not overdeveloped, it is not underdeveloped. So this mount is in a good condition. There is a fish sign. I can see there is a fish sign, so it is very good on Saturn mount. If you have a fish sign on Saturn mount, it will help you to earn money. These people, they earn money and they don't want to show that money to other people. I can see that there are so many small lines on your Saturn mount. So straight lines are very good. Straight lines should be there on your Saturn mount, because it indicates that you will have good amount of money, acquired money in your old age. So it indicates this thing, your old age will go very smoothly. So it also indicates this thing. So but there are some lines that are going like this. So this is not that much good kind of sign. So it indicates that you may have some problems, like related to your skin or related to your bones. So this thing is not that much good, but it is not that much serious, or don't worry. So your Jupiter mount is okay, and so there is a cross sign on your Jupiter mount, and it indicates that, it again indicates that you know, your marriage will be love marriage. You will marry to that person to whom you like or you love. So this indicates this thing. So this is a good thing. And you have square signs on your Jupiter mount. So many square signs are there. So these are also very good. It indicates that you have very good quality of teaching. You can do a job, or, you know, a teacher job. So these are called teacher square. You can explain the things to others very easily. And people also love the way you make them understand, because you have that quality in you, because you have teacher square in your hand. You have ring of Solomon on your Jupiter mount. So these indicate that you have trust in astrology, palmistry. You have triangle on your Jupiter mount also. So these kind of people, they go for higher studies. They are very much educated. You don't have ambition line that much. So these kind of people, they don't have you know, very particular kind of ambition. They don't think so much about their ambitions and their goals. They just go with the flow, and they don't have that much kind of ambition. I don't know, you didn't ask me about anything like your business or job, so I guess you must not have that kind of you know, thing in your mind that I want to do this in my life, I want to do that in my life. So until and unless you don't have ambition line on your Jupiter mount, you will not feel like doing something in your life. So these lines are very important. Next is your aggressive Mars, your inner Mars. So there is no bad sign on your aggressive Mars. So but it is not that much developed, and your defensive Mars is also is not that much good. You don't have that much energy in your body, like you don't feel active all the time. You feel, sometimes you feel very low, and your immunity power is also very less. So if I compare both the mounts, so your inner Mars is better than your outer Mars. So it indicates that if you start anything in your life, like any kind of thing, if you want to start a business, if you want to start a job, you start it with full of energy, but after some time you will not feel that much energetic to carry it on. So this is the thing with these kind of people. So these are your inner and outer Mars kind of situation. And now I'll tell you about your Venus. Your Venus is very good. You have got a Venus mount, you know, very big Venus mount in your hand, and very powerful mount on your hand. So Venus mount is very powerful on your hand. These kind of people, they are very good in they are very good in acting. They are very good in, you know, they like things which gives us luxury, and they love to do like makeup, and they love to dress very well, and they always attract to those things which are you know, which give us luxury. So if you have good Venus, so it indicates that you it will also help in your marriage. So this is the thing. And if you want to start any kind of job or business in your life, so you should do that kind of job which is related to the luxury items. Like you can do a business related to makeup or related to clothes, like these kind of business you can start if you want to start something in your life. So Venus is very, very good, and there are so many lines on your Venus mount, and it indicates that whenever you start something in your life, you will get the results very fast. So whatever you do, if you are a student, you are preparing for your exam, you will definitely pass that exam. So these lines indicate this thing. These are very good signs. So there are some luxury lines also, small luxury lines. So if you have luxury lines on your Venus mount, you should do something like, if you are doing something like job or business, this is good thing. But if you are not doing anything, so you should wake up early in the morning and do some exercise, because these lines also give laziness. So these line indicates this thing also. Your moon mount is also very clear, and it is a good thing that your moon mounts don't have any negative sign. But there are small lines. These are also called travel lines. These are small travels, and there is a line which is going upwards, and it is it is going to your fate line. And I told you about this line before, that this line also called a sister line, and it is also a long travel line. So you, on your moon mount, there are so many travel lines, so definitely you will travel in your life. And these lines also give anxiety sometimes, and these kind of people, they think so much, and they think the useless things, they think about the useless things, and they get tensed so many times. So this is the problem with these kind of people also. And your moon mount is good. You must like milk products, and you must like water very much, and moon mount is good, so your thoughts, they are also very clean and clear and deep. So this is your moon mount. And now I'll not analyze your outer Mars, because I have talked about it before, but there are some litigation line on your outer Mars, so these are not good actually. These are like you have to face some kinds of things related to court, and you should take care of that thing. So but that these lines they are, this line is little bit deeper, so this may give you some problem in future. So take care of that thing. And these litigation lines can give you, or they can not give you, some problem like this. Like if you want to buy some vehicle, or you have to go to the court for that purpose also. So this thing also indicate that thing also. So don't worry that much about that thing. If something happens in your life about court and all, so you can contact me, you can ask me about it at that time. This was your outer Mars, and now I'll analyze your lines. So this is your heart line, and you can see there is a formation of chain on your heart line. This thing also not good. If you have this kind of formation, this indicates that if your father and mother have some health issues, like some diseases, like sugar, high blood pressure, or something else, there are chances that you also may have those issues. Your heart line goes like this, and it ends in your Jupiter mount. And these kind of people whose heart line stops on their Jupiter mount, they are very emotional type of people, and they are very kind people. This thing is good that they are very kind, but sometimes it is very bad for them, because some people, they take advantage of this thing, and this is not a good thing for you. So always be careful. Don't give your money to those people who are not in need, but they are pretending to you that they are in need, and give them, please give me some money. They borrow some money from you, and they will not give you back. And this thing can, happen to you. So be careful. Now I'll analyze your mind line. Your mind line is not good initially, but after 30, it is becoming good, and it is falling on your moon mount. So your thoughts are very deep, and you think very, deeply, and you take things very seriously, and you think very deeply about the situation. And this thing also gives you sometimes, anxiety kind of thing. So don't think that much. And always keep your self calm. So your mind line is long, it is not short, it is long. So if you want to do something in your life, you should always do a permanent thing. Like if you want to start a business, you have to give 5-6 years to your business, and then your business will grow. And if you have ancestral business and you can continue with that, in that case you don't have to worry about giving so much years to your business, because in that case you don't have to wait that much to grow your business. So if you don't have ancestral business, you want to start your own business, so you have to give it 5 or 6 years at least, and after that your business will grow. This is the thing. And if you don't want to do any business, so job will be very good for you, because these kind of mind line people, they I always suggest them to do job, because job is the best option for them. Now I'll analyze your lifeline. your lifeline starts from here and it goes like this. So initially it is again not very good. Your childhood was not very good. You always remain sick, and then it starts from here and then it goes like this. Your age is 33, so I think your age, it comes, yeah, so your age is 33, this point is 35, so this point is 35, sorry, this point is 35, so age must be around here. So here lifeline is not in a round shape, it is like in a straight shape like this. So your energy level I think is not that much good. You don't feel very much energetic, and I think you always remain sick. Most of the time you remain sick, and your health is not that much good that you feel energetic and you feel very good. You have to you know, if you will feel good, you want to do something in your life, but your health don't allow you. Near 48 or after 50, you will face some health issues because your lifeline, it is not here in this area, as you can see. So this indicates that you may face some health issues in that age. So, and after that, your lifeline is going like this. So it is becoming better. But this gap in your lifeline, it indicates that you may face some health issues in this 10 years, because this kind of gap shows that 10 or 12 years you may have some health issues. So be careful at that time. But here I can see your angel line is coming down, and it is also covering this area. So it shows that if you have angel line in that defected area, so it gives you the it protects you from that problem. This line called angel line only because it is it acts like an angel, so it will protect you from this difficult time because you have angel line. Yes, you can see here is your angel line, it is going like this. So you have angel line in this particular time period. So it is a good news for you that you may not face that much big problem in your life. If you will get sick or you will have something like bad in your life, you have not to face it in a very bad way, in a very you will not be in a very bad condition. So because of this angel line, you can be able to face that problem in a easy way. So now next is your fate line. So your fate line starts from here. So it is going like this. It stops here and then it overlaps and again it starts. So it indicates that in a very younger age you started earning, like in 22 or 23. When you were 23 or 22 years old, you started earning. So it indicates that because it starts from here. So now your age is 33. So let me check your age. Yes, it is somewhere on this point. Your age is 35, like on this point. But your age is 33, so must be around here. So your fate line is in a very good condition, I would say. So it is in a very good condition. So you are not facing that much kind of financial struggle in your life in this age. If you are doing a job or a business, so it must be going very well. After 40, you will change your business or you will change your job. So it indicates this thing because it is overlapping here and it is going like this. And your fate line is good, but here it stops. Now I cannot see any kind of fate line on your Saturn mount. Yeah, it is going slightly to your Sun mount, and it again it shows that you may have chance to go foreign land, and maybe you can can be able to settle down there also, because it indicates this thing also. You don't have any fate line in this area. After 50, don't have any fate line. It indicates that if you are earning at that time 1 lakh or 2 lakh rupees, or if you are not earning anything, your financial status will remain the same. it is not like that if your fate line is missing, your you will lose your money or you will not have anything because fate line is not there. It is not like that. Your financial status will remain the same, and it is not a bad sign. But yeah, I'm not saying it is not, it is a good sign. Whatever you will earn in this age, it will depend on your hard work, that how much hard work you give to your work, and that the thing will decide how much you will earn. If you will not do any kind of hard work, you will not get anything, and if you will do hard work and you will try to earn money, you will get that amount of money at that age, I would say. So after, I would say 70, it shows. So it indicates that your old age will go smoothly. So this thing is good for your self, and you also have a square sign on your Saturn mount. So this thing is very, very good for your, health wise. It is very, very good, because if somebody have square sign and this that much big square sign on their Saturn mount, they are they are kind of people, they become sick. They if they have something very serious kind of problem in their life, like if they have some accident or some very big kind of disease, they recover very soon because of this square sign on their Saturn mount. This square sign is very good, and this square sign is on this area where your fate line supposed to go. So it also protects your money. It will also protect your money and your health also. So this is a very good sign on your hand. So that was your fate line. I have already analyzed your sun line before, so I'll not analyze your sun line again. So one more thing I want to tell you, that about this line, this sister line, this line also indicates that after marriage, you will have good in-laws in your life, supportive in-laws in your life, and your husband, he will be very supportive, and you will do something, you will feel like doing something after your marriage. If you are not doing anything in this age, when you get married, you will feel like doing something like business or job or anything. You will become ambitious after marriage, and in that thing, your husband and your in-laws will support you, and your marriage life will be very, very good, and you will enjoy your married life. Now I'll talk about your Mercury line, but I can't see any Mercury line in this area, but there is a line, a faded line, like you can see an impression of a line, small line. So I think it's your Mercury line, and it is not that much strong, so it is not increasing the power of your Mercury mount. So this is the thing. And another thing is, I have found this line in your hand, and it is going like this, and this is your lifeline, and it is touching it. This line, I think this is your addiction line. So if you have any kind of addiction, so please leave it as soon as possible. I'm not saying that you are addicted to drugs or alcohol, but some people also addicted to pills, like they take different kind of pills, and they got addicted. Like nowadays, kids are very addicted to games. Like there are so many kind of addictions, so I don't know which kind of addiction you have. If it is an addiction line, so you must have some addiction, so let me know about it. And if you have any kind of addiction, so leave it as soon as possible, because this line is not that much dark. It is kind of very light line, and if you will not stop that thing, doing that thing, so it will become darker, and it it can harm your finance, because it is touching your fate line. So it is not touching your lifeline, so I would say that it will not harm your health. So be careful about that. Let's talk about your marriage lines. There are so many marriage line in your hand. There are three main marriage lines in your hand, and this one is the main, because it is big and it is very dark kind of marriage line. Let's predict the age of your marriage. You will get married at the age of 35. So that was the prediction for your marriage. And you have cross on Jupiter, so your married life will be good also. So that was my predictions on your hand. I hope you like this video, and I hope I have covered all the points and I have cleared all the doubts. So that was my analysis of this hand. I hope you like this video. You can subscribe to my channel. If you want to analyze your hand, please check my description box. I have given all the details in my description box. You can send me an email. I have given my email ID, and please like this video. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye and take care.